Hey, good morning, students. I'm Sai Krishna from DBS Institution. Now going to take class regarding bridge engineering of Unit 5. Unit 5 belongs to piers and abutments. In last class, we have seen what is meant by piers and what is meant by abutments. And we had rough idea regarding this diagram, and I have explained more regarding this diagram. Okay, let me once again share what is meant by piers and abutments with respect to this diagram. Okay, initially we could find here foundation, substructure and superstructure. Foundation is nothing but that all lies under the ground level. In bridge construction comes under foundation. And what is meant by substructure? Substructure is nothing but it is a level between two portions known as foundation and superstructure is known as substructure. In substructure, what is lie? Abutments and piers are lies in between superstructure and foundations. Okay. What are abutments and piers with respect to normal commercial buildings or residential buildings? There we call as columns. Here we mention it as piers. And here abutments are nothing but the support that lies within either side of the bridge. Okay. Above the substructure, we could find a superstructure. Superstructure is nothing but a deck. The deck may be a concrete or steel, or it may be a composite deck slab, including RC posts and parapet railing. If you see below the substructure, there is foundation. Foundation may adopt various types of foundation for bridges. It may be like a spread footing or piles or wells, or it may be a caissons. Okay. I hope you all have a rough idea regarding this. What is meant by pier and abutment? Okay, next let me give a notations what are all here. Here it's a foundation. If you see above the foundation, a column here mentioned as a pier, and either side of the bridge for supporting we have abutments. Above a pier and abutments, firstly we have a bed block. Okay, above the bed block we have bearing pad. Bearing pad is nothing but it's a material that withstand the forces, sudden moments. Okay, above that we have a deck slab. Upon the deck slab we could find a materials or objects that are to be supportive for humans to travel in the road or the bridge, are like similarly like lamp posts, RC posts, parapet walls, etc. Okay, this is nothing but elevation of a typical bridge structure. Next, coming to bed block. What is a bed block and where it is placed? We should have a general knowledge regarding this. Okay. In this diagram, we have seen the bed block just lies upon a pier and abutment. Okay. And why they are laying, we should see in the following sentences. A reinforced concrete bed block resting over the top of the piers and abutments. Okay. In bed block, we are seeing a reinforced concrete bed block resting over the top of the piers and abutments is generally provided to evenly distributed and dead and live loads on the pier and the abutments. Okay. They are saying nothing but a bed block that is resting over the top of piers and abutments. That is by generally providing by distributed the dead and live loads on the pier and abutments. Hope you all understood. It is for distributing the upcoming load eventually totally to the piers and abutments. Okay. In figure 17.2, the reinforcement details in block, bed block, over piers, they are showing. They are the reinforcement details. A bed block is nothing but a concrete structure where the reinforcement looks like what we are seeing. The top diagram is nothing but the longitudinal section, and the bottom one is nothing but the top view of the sectional reinforcement. They have mentioned normally how does the reinforcements are given as a top and bottom. The bottom is followed by pier or a abutment. Okay. Next, going to materials for piers and abutments. We should be clear that what are the materials we are gonna be adopted while constructing piers and abutments, because it is a critical process to choose the materials for piers and abutments, because the entire structure of deck slab is resting on piers and abutments. So we should be much careful while recruiting the materials. Yes, the following types of materials are generally used for construction of piers and abutments. They are 1. Mass concrete of M10 grade corresponding to mix 1:3:6 with 40 mm maximum size of aggregates. Fine. If you use that, we have to use 40 mm. In second, they are going for reinforced concrete M15 grade corresponding to mix proportions of 1:2:4. Okay, that is fine. We could adopt that. 1:2:4 is nothing, but that's a mix ratio. Was fine cement, post aggregate, sand. Next, coming to point number 3, post the rubble masonry in cement mortar for proportions of 1:4. Okay. Next, coming to point number 4, that is nothing but D, that is brick masonry in cement mortar of proportions 1:6. Okay, cement mortar, that is nothing but coming to the proportions of 1:6 for brick masonry. Point number 6, the pre-stressed concrete for piers, particularly in Widex with tall piers concrete of M30 to M40 grade is the minimum requirement for pre-stressed concrete piers. Earlier we have studied in point number A, B only with respect to design mix of M10 and M15. Coming to point number 5 of pre-stressed concrete of piers, we are talking about a minimum strength of choosing of mixed design M32, M40 grade. Okay, be conscious here because it is a big structure gonna handle large loads that are coming from deck slab. That's what they are saying in the point number 5. So they are clearly mentioning M30 and M40 mixes grades are the minimum requirement when you're going to precess to concrete piers. The maximum permissible compressive and tensile stresses in the various types of materials in the substructure are compiled below as reported by Victor. Top 4. Okay. Types of piers. Okay. Now we know what are piers. Piers are nothing but the long vertical section, longitudinal sections that are arising from foundation. They are the joiners of deck slab compressing from foundations. Okay. Those piers may be of various types. That's what we are going to look in detail right now in class 17.4, types of piers. Types of piers. Depending upon the type, size, dimensions of the superstructure, types of piers are in general use. Okay. Maximum permissible stresses in various materials used for substructure. Here we could find the materials. Maximum permissible compressive stresses, maximum permissible tensile stresses that could adopt are for the following 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 was given here. Mass concrete. For mass concrete, 1:3:6 makes the maximum permissible compressive stresses is 2 Newton per mm square. And coming to maximum permissible tensile stresses are 0.25 Newton per mm square. Coming to next one, reinforced concrete of grade makes M15 grade was mentioned to maximum permissible compressive stresses to 4 Newton per mm square. And next, maximum permissible tensile stresses are 0.5 Newton per mm square. Coming to third one, coated rubble, they are 1.5 Newton per mm square, and for maximum permissible stresses it is 0.3 Newton per mm square. The coated rubbles are of masonry in cement mortar of ratio mix 1:4. Next, coming to fourth one, brick masonry in cement mortar is of mix 1:6 is of maximum permissible compressive stresses is 1 Newton per mm square, and next, maximum permissible stresses, tensile stresses are 0.02 Newton per mm square. Finally, it's for precessed concrete M40 grade, the maximum permissible compressive stresses is 14 Newton per mm square, and next, permissible tensile stresses are 3 Newton per mm square. It should not exceed. Okay. They have mentioned in types of pairs, depending upon the type, size, dimension, the pairs may be classified. First, type A. In type A, first type of pair is solid type pair. What is solid type pair? Now I'm gonna explain. A solid type pair is generally built using brick or stone masonry or concrete. This type with cut ease water is widely used for river bridges. The figure of that is shown in 7.3. Okay, the cross-sectional plan of typical solid concrete pier. Okay, what they are saying in solid type pier is nothing but it is built of brick or stone or concrete. This type is widely used in river bridges. Okay, let's have a quick look what is meant by solid pier. Okay, A, this is nothing but a solid pier. This is the structure of solid pier. It is totally a solid one. This is a pier. Next, trestle type pier. The trestle type pier comprises of number of reinforced concrete columns with a connecting cap at the top as shown in figure 17.3b. The trestle type of pier finds wide applicability in the case of flyovers and elevated roadways generally used for crossings in city roads. Okay, let's have a quick look. This is nothing but trestle type pier. And this is, we have seen earlier, solid pier. This solid pier used in rivers. This trestle type pier is used in normal road bridges. Next, coming to hammerhead type pier. The hammerhead type pier consists of massive single pier with cantilever caps on opposite sides resembling the head of a hammer. This type of pier is generally suitable for elevated roadways, and when used in river bridges, there is minimum restriction of waterway. A typical hammerhead type of pier is shown. Okay, here it's a pier, and this is nothing but bed block. And here we have piers. On top, we have a pier cap in trestle type pier. And next, coming to hammerhead type pier, it is used in roadways and also in river crossings. While we go for river crossing types, we use some precautions before using those. Okay, and the next one is cellular type pier. Okay, I hope you all seeing the image of cellular concrete pier. For the construction of massive piers carrying multi-lane traffic, is economically to use cellular type reinforced concrete piers, which results in savings of concrete. However, cellular piers requires costly shuttering and additional labor for placing of reinforcements. For tall piers, slip forming work can be adopted for rapid construction. A typical cellular type of pier is shown here. Okay, I hope you all could see that cellular pier. Okay, while comparing for first solid pier to cellular pier, here there's a gap where you could save lost of concrete because they are unwanted. Upon calculations, we use the amount of concrete in the necessary places. So these are the types of cellular piers. Next, framed type piers. The reinforced concrete type piers are aesthetically superior and rigid due to monolithic joints between the vertical or inclined and horizontal members as shown. This type of piers are ideally suited to reduce the span length of main girder on either side of the center line of the pier, resulting in savings of the cost of superstructure. However, this type of construction requires two expansion joints at close intervals with increase of maintenance. Okay. If you have any queries, let me know regarding the content we have seen right now in piers and abutments. Yes. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Thank you.